just two characters talking. There's a little bit of other stuff, like here at the beginning. But it's basically two characters sitting still, talking to each other. So just watch when we're looking at which person. You know, that sometimes the motivation to cut from one shot to another is that this person finishes talking and that person is about to start and you're done over here and you've got to go over here. But often, when you have a scene that's kind of emotionally complicated, you know, you want something better. That kind of editing gets kind of boring.
Robbie, listen. I live in Maryland, which means that you have residency in Maryland, for the University of Maryland.
Once you get that he's saying, I live in Maryland, with the University of Maryland, you want to be hearing the son take that in. You don't want to be watching him say it. I mean, we've already gotten his discomfort. I mean, ideally, you'd do everything in a split screen and watch everybody all the time, but that would be annoying, too. So you have to choose. And in this case, you know, going to the son. And then there's that moment where, you know, there's the two girls at the other table who kind of check him out, and George Clooney sees them checking him out. And just has that schlumpy look that he has, which you can tell, you can decide for yourself how you want to interpret that, but it's evocative.
I want a normal house. I want Cinemax and prom. You know what prom is like in Pakistan? Prom sucks.
Okay, it's complicated. You know?
Too often people kind of do this, you know, just ping-pong editing. And sometimes if the material, because this all has to be driven by the material, you can't impose some kind of interesting editing on boring footage. Sometimes you're very hard pressed to find a reason to cut, but you always want to feel like there's a reason. There's, you know, very often in a scene, sometimes you have to cut. Sometimes you have to cut from this away from this person because they blew their line. For some reason, you don't want to leave, but you have to leave.
Yeah.
So you want to cut to a reaction. So you want it to look to the audience like you cut away for a reason. Not that you cut away, then the reason shouldn't be because I had to get out of this shot because there was a problem. So, you know, one of the things you should tell your actors when you're directing things is when you're, you know, if somebody else is in a speech and you're sitting there, don't just do this. You know? Because how am I going to cut to that and make it look like I did it for a reason? What editors will always use is if you're listening, if your job in this section of the scene is to listen, you know, look away, look back. That's the simplest thing you can tell your actors. Look away and look back, because that's what the editor's going to use, guaranteed. And if there's four people who we could be cutting to, the one who looks away and looks back is the one who's going to get cut to. So, because very often you can find a place to do that to make it look like, oh, he's listening, that means something to him, just because it feels like something. And it's really hard to cut to somebody who's just sitting there and have it feel like it's motivated. So that's a simple, dumb trick. Tell all actors that, because I guarantee you, when you're editing, you're going to scan through the footage at high speed looking for one of these. because that's what will feel natural.